I'll give the name for the police. So let this pulley E. Any name? Let me choose some arbitrary that one. A, B. Okay, there's a pulley C. There's a pulley D. And let this be the pulley A, pulley B. Small letters. So how many mobile objects are there? Indicate their position. How many mobile objects are there? We have pulley B, so write LB for that. This will be capital B only. I'll take it. It doesn't make any difference. Yeah. LA and this block here, no? It's asking, no, increase gradually. How far will the block will shift? So here is the force F is applied. Now this pulley here, to look at the pulley here. The pulleys are massless. The net force on the pulley should be zero. This is what the concept which I'm going to apply in this numerical. Okay, look at the spring B and D, how they are. They're in series, no? They're connected by a common string. Try to see this spring B and A. Spring B and D are connected by a common string, that one. So therefore, what should be the spring force in them? They are identical, more or they are identical. If they are K1, K2, the elongation would have been different. So go back to the springs idea. If two springs are in series, then spring constant different, elongations will be different. If spring constant is same, then the elongations in both should be equal, that one. So therefore, the spring force acting in both the springs will be equal, that one. So here I'll show this F1, this F1. They're just based on the series parallel one only, nothing big. Now the problem is very, very simple. This F1. Okay, look at.
Sir, can you repeat the reason?
Springs, when they are in series, if K1 equal to K2, X1 will become equal to X2. If the springs in series, no, then if the spring constants are same, then the elongation in each spring must be equal. If the spring constants are different, then the elongations will be different. This idea, what we had learned in springs in series parallel, no, that going, I'm going to apply it. Based on that, I'm writing, this is F1. Okay, let's look at the pulley now. Pulley is a massless, no? So the net force on the pulley must be zero. So F1 and F1 is acting. So here, how much of force will act? So let it be F2. So this force will be F2. Nearby, you show like this. This is F2. This is F1. Okay, come for this. What should be the spring force? They should act on the pulley, on the spring A. What should be the net force on the pulley A? Should also be zero. So here, 2F1 was equal to F2. Look at this. 2F1 is equal to F2. So here, 2F1 is acting on pulley A. So what should be the force that should act here? So it should be F2. Okay, got the idea, no? So there's a method of, I think I'll just show arrow like this. this is on the pulley. On the spring. Okay, fine. So I'll look at this one. So there's a reason why I should assume the forces here. So these two springs, how they are? They're in series, same spring constant. So therefore, same spring force will act here. So what about spring A and C? Sir, you are assuming same force. Why I'm putting F2 in the spring C and D? Spring C and A, are they parallel or series? No, they are nowhere connected. But because of the net force on the pulley should be zero. So therefore, what happened? The spring force in both A and C should be equal to F2. Got this? So here, light pulley. Similar, this also light pulley. Let's come for that. What is F is equal to? F1 plus F2. F is equal to. I think problem is over. They're the most troublesome. Once you are able to do this much, you can manage here. And what is any other relationship? Look at any pulley. 2F1 should be equal to F2. The problem is over once you are able to cross this one. So let me substitute here. F equal to F1. F2 is 2F1. So F1 equal to F by 3. Substitute this. F2 should be equal to 2F by 3. Next, after this, let's come for the constraint equation. Let the block undergo displacement. The block will undergo displacement. So as the block shifts towards right, what will happen to springs? Springs will undergo deformation. And what happened to pulley B and A will also shift it, no? So any constraint equation, can you write it? Any constraint equation. Sir, what do you mean by constraint equation? What you want to write here? See, as I shift the block towards right. Tell me what happened to elongation in all the springs. Zero, non-zero. Will it be non-zero? So the springs will get the springs will get elongated. And the block shifts towards right, the springs will get elongated and also the pulleys will get displaced here. Now, let's look at the spring B and D. So can you write equation? So if the block, I'll display the block towards right. So what should be the displacement of block? Delta L should be the displacement of the block. So here I'll make assumption. Why delta L? You see at what distance the block is from the wall. The wall is a reference I'm taking. For the displacement of pulleys, everything, the wall is a reference. The wall is a reference here. So if you want to write it, this as origin, write this as origin. Okay, now let's come for this. Let delta L be the displacement of block. So I'll write it. Let delta L be the displacement of block. Let delta L1 be the displacement of block in the, so delta X1, let it be the elongation in the springs B and D. So I'll assume few things. Delta X1. Because why delta X1? Because spring force F1 is acting. Delta X1 be the elongation in springs B and D. Similarly, delta X2 elongation in springs A and C. What is delta L? Delta L is the displacement of the block. So we have to calculate the delta L. How these springs B and D are there in series. So what is the total elongation? 2x1. So what that 2x1 should be equal to? So how that spring B will get elongated because of displacement of pulley B? Then again here, the change in length of this part of the string, and also again the displacement of the relative displacement between block B and A will make the spring to elongate. No, so what is that elongation in the springs B and D, because they are in series? Okay, fine. Yeah, that one. So I'll write it here. No, the total elongation in the springs B and D, 2x1, the sum of elongations in the spring B and D, delta x1 plus delta x1. What this I should write? Displacement of pulley B with respect to wall plus displacement of pulley with respect to pulley A okay, find this. Then displacement of block with respect to pulley A. So this should be equal to 2 delta x1 is equal to 2 delta lb minus 2 delta la plus delta l. If you can understand this, the problem is over. All of you agree this? So what is the total, the sum of elongation? Why both springs B and D will have same elongation? Because they are in series, they are having same spring constant. So I'll write this equation. The elongation of, the sum of elongation in the springs B and D should be equal to. How do they get this much of elongation? When this pulley B moves towards right, when pulley A moves towards right, and when the block moves towards right. So what all that as elongation in the springs, that should be equal to delta LB plus change in length of the displacement of pulley plus change in increase in length of this part of the string plus the relative displacement of block with respect to pulley. So because of this, what happened? Both the springs will have elongation this much. Okay, got the idea now? So call this equation one. Now, similarly, can you discuss about the springs? Spring A, any equation for spring A? So let elongation in spring A and C is how much? Delta x2. So delta LA, will you write equal to just delta x2? Delta LA, is it equal to delta x2? These two are, what is this equation for springs? Springs B and D. Okay, now for spring A, will write the equation. Anybody, spring A, the elongation in that, how much? Let it be equal to delta x2. We assumed it. So here delta x2 should be equal to delta LA, only that much. Now, what is the elongation in the spring C? That is also equal to delta x2. Any equation for that?
Delta L minus delta L.
The block will have displacement delta L and the block pulley B will move. So delta L minus delta LB should be equal to delta X2. This is for what? I'll write for spring C. Delta L minus delta XB is equal to delta X2. Okay, this you take equation 2, equation 3. What we should do now, how to bring forces. So what is Fn? Fn shall I write equal to K delta X1? Next some equations I'm bringing. Fn should be equal to, okay, first we'll do one thing. Let me solve all this one. Any relation between delta L, delta X2, delta X1? Solving 1, 2, 3. Shall I write directly? Shall I write directly? I can save some time. Solving 1, 2, 3. Solving 1, 2, and 3. Let me write equation directly. I'm still able to remember that answer. Equal to 2 delta x1. Yeah. This is the relationship between them. Okay, after this, what is f1 should be equal to? K delta x1. And what should be the f2 should be equal to? K delta x2. Regarding spring forces, I'll write it here. Okay, now I think we are in comfortable. And what is f1, f2? We have these values. So what I should do here now, delta x2 should be equal to f1 by k1. Delta x2 is equal to f2 by k, substituting here. And we know f1, f2. Solving that, we'll get final answer. You check your calculation later on. The idea I gave it. The equation 4. This is equation 4, 5, 6. This is equation. You write P. So solving what happened here? So putting 5, 6, P in 4, what happened? We'll get the required answer. I'll little bit slide up. I'll okay, I'm just filling up everything in one page here. Okay, no, so this one, just it's the calculations. You take care later on. I'll go for next one. Equation one is what? The sum of elongation in the springs. The sum of elongation in the springs B and D, the sum of elongations in the springs B and D, how do they get elongated? When the block pulley B and A, when the pulley is B and A, and the block will undergo displacement, no? That I'm writing that constraint equation. Displacement of pulley B, then the change in length of, due to displacement of pulley B, due to displacement of pulley A, due to displacement of block, what happened? The springs B and D will get elongated. That constant equation is what we are writing here. Okay. Okay, come for this. So some